Hey.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's how y'all start off.
What is up? It's your girls, Never Not Extra, here on this young Tuesday.
Tuesday.
It's your girl, Kirsten.
And Moni.
And we're back at it again.
With another episode for the people.
For the people.
The people being
fist up.
You said what?
Fist up. Fist up. For the people.
Yes.
We also have two special guests with us tonight. Millie Rocks. Millie Rocks. Okay. Okay. introduce yourself.
I am Keyshawn Malone, a.k.a. Pleasure Key. How y'all doing out there?
Oh, Lord.
Okay.
Oh, Lord.
All right.
Yeah, Mark Henderson, it's the homie. I ain't got no AKAs like that, so you can just, you know.
MH Deuce.
Yeah, you can call me Deucey if you want. It's cool.
Deuce. We kind of bullied Mark into.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, he was not trying to get on the mic.
I came
but for,
you know, just to be support system.
Don't let him lie to y'all. He knew. He already knew this was going to happen.
I mean, I had an idea. Gosh. I had an idea, you know.
It's all good. Well, you got your support. You got your male support.
Right.
Some.
Yeah, you know.
They don't really rock with me as you think they do.
Oh, my. Here we go. Look, we're about to have a bro moment.
I know.
A little bromance going on.
Anyways.
Well, that was a shot at me. That went over my head, bro. I'm sorry.
Oh, my gosh.
They're not in sync like that. So the reason for our male attendance on the show, because the subject of today is, quote, unquote,
you ain't my bitch.
You ain't my bitch, a.k.a. you not my girl. But we can also make it you not my man, too.
Right.
I didn't even know we can cuss on here.
I mean, So we're going to be basically stating facts on each side, right?
Yeah. No, I got all this laid out.
Oh, you got it laid out? All right, bet.
Yeah, so we're going to be talking about you not my girl, basically some boundaries, some rules, and the talking stage of relationship that's not really a relationship, but it's kind of like a relationship. But, you know, communication gets crossed, so... Yeah, you know, you feel me?
Yeah. Oh, no, definitely. It does get, that's the subject that everybody's dealt with.
Every fucking body.
Everybody.
This day and age. But before that.
I never dealt with that.
How are y'all doing? How was y'all week? You say you never dealt with this.
Week just getting started. Today's honestly just day one of the week.
For you? Oh, y'all.
Oh, no. We did have practice. No, yeah. No, it's day two. It's day definitely two. Day two. It's day two.
Solid. Though. You know, it's early in the. It's almost Friday. Once you get to Wednesday, I mean, once Wednesday's in, I feel like the weekend's here. To be
I feel
honest.
Like that's yeah, Thursday's always my day. Tough shit hits on Wednesdays. What about you, Kirsten?
You never call me that on the radio. I'm so proud of you. I guess it was cool. I mean, I was mad that I wasn't off yesterday.
I was too.
And I was like, you know, my dad and my grandpa are veterans. Like, I should get to leave early so I can spend the day with them.
Your dad and your grandpa.
Veteran.
They fought for this country.
You didn't.
And the country don't care about them. So I need to be with them to appreciate them. And when I called my dad, he was like, Veterans Day was on Sunday, Shayna.
Oh, it was?
I was like, yeah, it was. I knew that. But they acknowledge it on Monday.
For what?
But anyways, we didn't have it off. I was mad. But other than that, I mean, I guess my week has been good. I've been kind of like catching up on sleep because, you know, I had all those kids over the weekend.
You had like Shayna daycare.
It sounds like you're going through it.
I had a 7-year-old, a 1-year-old, and an 11-month-old over the weekend.
That sounds like a headache.
Team no sleep.
You're all right. But, yeah. It's just getting you ready for the future.
But,
near future. Ask you.
The future. Excuse me?
The future can start tomorrow. You never know.
You
Money
never
trying to
know.
Drop dimes. On air.
I mean, you know, yeah, insider info. Wow, I'm just kidding.
Don't do that.
No, but no, my week has been, it's been pretty good. I listened to Keith's show on time for the first time.
Start your
yesterday.
Week with Keith.
Start your week with Monday morning with Keith Good News.
What time Monday morning?
8:30 on Monday morning.
He be shedding some light.
He talked about fruit flies yesterday.
Ooh.
Everybody hates fruit flies. Yeah.
I haven't listened that's in a while. I need to listen and get my week.
Yeah, so that started my week off right. I was actually in the middle of a meeting and I lied and said I was on hold to speak with my doctor, but I was listening to the show and it got my week started off right. So
that's far,
so
right good. There.
Glad to hear.
That's good.
My week's been good, I guess. Okay, not that I wanted this. Not that I wanted this at all. But I figured that over the weekend with the fires, with my job being in Glendale, I figured that the air quality will be bad. And they would be like, oh, y'all got to stay home because the air quality is bad. But that didn't happen. It was clear skies. But prayers to the people affected by the fires.
I think a lot of people wanted the fires to just affect their whole work situation.
They wanted it to.
Yeah, I kind of did. I'm not going to lie.
I'm surprised y'all didn't have, like, shit closed.
Nah, it didn't reach us like that.
In L.A. it did, but not really. Not so much in South Bay.
The air quality, yes.
True.
I work in Santa Monica, so, like, you could see the smoke, but it didn't affect that much, so... But like you could see it, like they definitely was like, you know, cautious because the air quality. But it was like, so where we like practice and coach at, it definitely didn't reach the South Bay.
Oh, sure.
Shout out North Torrance, by the way.
Yep,
got a championship game this Friday.
It's
show
lit.
The boys love.
It's lit.
It's not a championship game, bro. I don't want to.
It's the second round of.
I don't
want
to jinx this.
Lord.
I mean, it's to get to the championship. It's
to, it is to get to the championship, but bro, we need it's the semis.
Damn, how y'all feel like coaching football? It make y'all feel old?
Nah. Because, I mean, they be listening to turn music just like we be listening to music.
Because, like, the age gap ain't that far. Yeah. Like, it's a far age gap, but it's not. Like, because the fact that, like, we're kind of, like, we're still pretty much young, you know? So we can, and we listen to the same music these kids listen to, going through the same stuff. So,
just think about how you was your senior year in high school. You feel like you the shit. You feel like you know everything.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's how they are.
Yeah.
They still young and dumb, but they still be partying like we do. But I think social media made it worse, though. They party.
These kids go
hard
now.
I wasn't partying in high school.
Shit.
I really
plead the fifth.
I mean,
nah.
They be turnt after we win games. They be having their own little thing on Saturday nights.
Yeah, they do.
They be going in.
Nah, but it's like, yeah, I do feel old because it's like, damn. For me, at least, it's like, okay, it's pretty much 10 years out of high school. But the fact that I can relate to these kids, because like, you know, I used to be one of these type kids, so it's easy to relate to them. That's why I don't make you feel old, because it's like we doing something that we know we comfortable with doing. And that we know. So it's just teaching, basically. And just keeping them, trying to just make them not make mistakes, but because they're high school senior boys or just football boys in general, they're going to do stupid stuff.
Pregnancies
like,
and stuff?
Not pregnancies, but I think our guys, they know not to get nobody pregnant and stuff, but everything else is like, who knows?
I think the biggest thing is the following trends.
Yeah.
It's the biggest thing.
Word.
Well, back to your point of what you call them? You said young and
dumb.
Young and dumb, and it was something else you called them too.
Damn.
I don't remember. But speaking of young and dumb,
word
on this topic, young
word?
And dumb niggas.
Come on.
and women and dumb women.
And dumb
Thank
women.
You, we can end.
It definitely goes both ways, but because of society, you know, the guy's going to always
get the bash.
Yeah, but
well, we'll see. We got y'all here to defend the men, so we don't sound ignorant. I should say.
After we discuss it, y'all gonna be on our side too.
But I mean,
we'll see.
There's definitely reasons why things happen. So like, I'm sure like there are like some guys that causes certain situations. I get it, but that's why this is the topic of, you know, are we dating? Like, where are we at?
Yeah,
that's why it has to be a for real understanding. But it would never be a for real understanding because we just different.
Okay, so getting into the topic.
Yeah.
So you can say your piece. have you ever had to pull the "you're not my girl" card?
Yes.
On somebody?
Yes.
How?
But I mean, I'm here, but just had to just really. I'm trying to get it together. Just had to so I could work this right. But just have to for real, just be like. We never took it to that level. So I get it. Like, we've done some things or whatever, but it's like...
Would she start wilding?
Not wilding. Just, you know, people expect things from people, especially if you're in that position of, like, I have feelings for you or whatever. People going to feel entitled to certain things or entitled to certain behaviors. But you got to be like, if it's no title...
No understanding.
No understanding, then it's like you shouldn't feel this way.
True.
And why you feel like she shouldn't feel that way?
Because we're not together.
Oh, okay. Was that discussed?
And if it's definitely not discussed, then don't assume anything.
Exactly. Yeah, that's so true. Excuse the hell. I tell my story.
No, for real though. Like I get it. We vibing. We doing this and that. But it's like it still wasn't brought up. You didn't bring it up. I didn't bring it up. So
yeah. So have you ever had that card pulled on you?
Yeah.
But I've never acted that way.
No, that's a yes or no question. Have somebody ever had to tell you, you're not my nigga?
Nah. Because I don't react. And if I know I'm not your nigga, I'm not about to act like I'm your nigga.
Okay.
Simple as that.
The easiest way is you talk about it.
I'm dead at Montoya's comments. That what you laughing at?
Yes.
What'd you say?
He said, I'm here to make sure these niggas don't lie. I hear two already. Oh, niggas is lying? Wow. Are you lying?
I ain't lying.
Are you lying?
Don't let that man fool you.
No, that's the liar right there. Like,
don't let that man fool
you. I talk about niggas who lie. That's the nigga, but he ain't here, so I ain't going to speak up on him.
He can't defend himself, so he good.
I tell the truth.
Dude, have y'all been in this situation before? I want to know.
No, we asking you first.
Oh, that's fine. You can ask me.
Go ahead.
Have you had to pull the card?
Never. I always talk about it. Every girl I ever talk to first, I would tell you straight up, hey,
definitely.
Either this is what you want. I'm not ready for a relationship. Either you can handle this or you can leave.
I bet you they don't fucking tell the truth with that. They be like, oh, okay, I'm not looking for a relationship either.
But some girls be on the same way. I had a problem with a girl. We never spoke about it. She actually told me she didn't want a relationship. I'm like, all right, cool. We get in public though, you know, we partying. She want to kiss me and stuff. I'm like, hey, now you shouldn't be. Don't do that. I don't do that type of stuff. I don't just be kissing random people in public like that, sweetie. I just
random.
I mean, she got pissed about it, but I mean, we established that from day one. My thing is stay on your word.
Yeah.
If you say you don't want it either, don't get mad at it because it's.
A lot of women don't be knowing.
I don't think
that's very true.
Or they get into things thinking that they can handle a situation, but let me tell you what
the ultimate thing is. A lot of women, and you can get mad at me because I don't fucking care. A lot of women will just agree with a guy when he says, "Oh, I don't want a relationship." They'll be like, "Oh yeah, I don't want a relationship either," because subconsciously they think that, "Oh well, I'm different and I can change him." Like women always think that they can change a man's mind. If a man is telling you something, that's what it is, boo. Like you can't change it.
A man taught me that. A nigga will say what they mean. Girls will be like, "Oh, you know, dancing around it," but a nigga will say what they mean.
Put in their own perspective how they mean. Me personally, I don't see how it could be a problem. If you talk about this shit, it's so easy.
Okay, I'll tell my story. I never had to, maybe I need to think some more. I don't think I've ever had to pull that on somebody. But I did, somebody had to pull that on me and be like, you're not my girl.
What did you do?
I started acting.
I know you was pissed. At the moment, I know you was pissed.
Always mad. I was hella pissed.
The rejection is always like,
I was hella pissed. And to me, my argument was more of like, well, nigga, yes, I am, you know? Like,
that's crazy.
Damn, you losing this battle right now. Yeah.
So basically, we were talking, and I was calling him, and he was not answering the phone. And I could see that he was, like, on social media.
Mm. Was you lit?
Damn, man,
I was not lit,
shit,
but
that's crazy.
But it wasn't even nothing important. I just was mad that he wasn't answering the phone. He was, like, clearly ignoring me. And I was like, you ain't gonna answer the phone, you know, like wilding, like, oh, like I don't fuck with you, and I don't gotta. And he was like, "You talking all that shit, but you not my girl." And I was like,
"You a soccer?"
No, she's like, definitely the violent one. I can tell. She pressed lines early.
No, I'm like, I've never put my hand on a nigga because I don't ever want a dude to hit me back.
It didn't register. Like, oh shit, I need to fall. It was like, what the fuck you mean? Like,
did y'all have this discussion before though, or like it was just?
No, we definitely had the discussion before, but I felt like we spent all the time together. Like, how you not?
But see, and it's crazy because that's it sucks though because like guys do that, like, you know, kicking it.
Oh yeah,
no, definitely. Well,
to be honest,
not at this point.
I don't even have to ask. I know he was hitting it good for the point of you tripping on him like this.
That's usually what it stemmed down to.
It has to be.
Not just that, but this be that though.
Yeah, like, nigga was putting it down some type of way for you to be like,
no, I am.
Like, I am your girl.
Well, I didn't say that, but I was just like, I was more like, okay, but you still need to answer the phone when I call.
It does suck though. Because, like, I can get it if, like, you know, we've been kicking it, hanging out and shit. Mm-hmm. So it's like, you know, the behaviors and the vibes are saying, like, you know, we're an item, we're together. Like, I can get it from that standpoint.
Yeah.
But it's like you still got to set things out.
Niggas is at fault too. They know what they're doing.
No, yeah, definitely.
They do.
They know what they're doing.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's what I'm saying. Like,
but I mean, if you gonna keep going with the flow,
why would
I change it?
You gotta You gotta wise up or just be like,
why would I change
it? Okay, this nigga's is nothing going.
Yep. For what? What's the purpose of changing it? We're good.
And that's how men are. We not about to mess up nothing. Well, we about to keep stuff.
Only thing you want right now is a title. That's the only thing that's different.
Well. And exclusivity. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But you could be doing that too. You could be, depending on how serious
then
thing
what's
is.
The problem?
A nigga just might not want to be in a relationship.
That's crazy. I'm not
being exclusive with nobody if we just talking and dating.
The
exclusivity, that's when it's like, okay, it's for me, at least that's like, because she's for sure my girl.
I've grown up since then, obviously. I'm not finna like, but the thing is, I did end up being his girl, so,
That won't work.
How
was one for one, one for two.
I got what I wanted, shit.
Like, I think I told you.
Hey, keep swinging.
I definitely had to hit somebody with, you not my nigga.
Mm-hmm.
Only because he was wildin'.
You give me that vibe, like you press lines.
What did you do?
Look.
Like, you press lines, for sure.
Let me tell you. First of all, I don't know who the fuck this nigga thought he was talking to. Like, I don't know. But basically, like, I was talking to multiple dudes at this time.
True pimp.
I'm not a pimp, but it was just like I wasn't like in a committed relationship, and the nigga was like trying to tell me what to do, and it's like, no, nigga, like my last name is Dabney, nigga, not whatever the fuck your last name is. So
she be personalized.
No.
You went really hard though, like
what she is.
What did he say for you?
This is my thing. This is my thing. If you're not calling me your girl, and we not going out in public, and we not doing relationship stuff, then you're not my nigga. You can't tell me what to do. Period.
I understand that.
That makes sense.
But what was y'all doing then?
Literally, all we did was talk on the phone.
Oh, that's whack.
And then it was just like every time it came to, like, I literally just talked to him like when I was bored, because it was just like
y'all both playing games.
Because when it came down to going out, he always had some drastic fucking story, like, oh dang, my brother got my stick stuck on my car. What? Or it was just like, oh dang, like me and my mama just got in this argument and now she hiding my house keys from me.
The fuck?
Like, it was always something tragic. No, it's not catfish. I seen him in person all the time. Like, I always hung out. I always like hung out like at his job and all this other stuff. But it was just like, nigga, like you on some bullshit. So it's like you're always on bullshit. So then I was at his job and we were all at the bar. And then I invited the other guy that I was talking to.
Wow, that's fucked up, though. That's fucked up. I get why, but the nigga
this is
talk,
a Twitter
nigga,
thread right now.
Real. I mean, he probably was like, all right, I got it here. This is my chance. And then the next nigga come along.
No, that
like,
wasn't his chance. I always hang up there. I always hang out there. So, no. So, I invited the guy that, and I was with my friends and stuff, too. So, then he was like, oh, why you all up in that nigga face? And I'm like, because I could be in whoever face I want to be in. Like, you're not my nigga.
You got older brothers? Or anything?
I have two younger brothers.
Yo, we call you Rough Rider. You're a Rough Rider.
Press lines.
I'm just saying, like, niggas can't tell me what to do. Period.
I get that.
But I feel it, though.
But damn, I mean, to bring a nigga when he's there.
He's not my nigga.
You're right, but he's trying to get at you is what I'm saying.
He wasn't trying hard enough.
I mean, you was kind of dissing him, too.
No, I wasn't. If I ask you, if I say, hey, I got movie tickets, let's go to the movies. Oh, my stick is stuck on my car. I was like, okay, I'll come get you. Oh, no.
My mom got
in an argument, and she hid in my house keys.
Okay, the mom thing, I'd have been pissed about that as a person. I'd be like, well, you need to grow up, nigga.
Right. Like,
But I mean.
But it's just like, he just had too many excuses, and I know when somebody is full of shit, and he was definitely full of shit.
So why y'all kept talking so much then? Like on the
because
phone?
I could talk to him when I was bored.
Was you attracted to him or anything?
I was attracted to him maybe like the first 3.5 weeks that we were talking, and then I didn't like him no more.
So why you just never told him, like, you know what, I don't want to talk to you?
Because he wouldn't leave me alone. Like, I told him I didn't want to talk to him, but then I didn't want to be like a rude bitch because I still hung out at his job with all of my friends because all of my other friends worked there too. So it was just like, I didn't want it to be awkward. So I was like, all right, cool.
Wilding.
I was like, but, you know, whatever. And then it's just like all of a sudden, like, oh, that's why I didn't want to talk to you. Like, nigga, shut the fuck up. Don't try to make me feel bad because I don't. So
if he probably watching this show, like, I swear to God, I hate her.
He definitely does not like you.
Playing me, I swear to
definitely
God,
hates you.
Oh well.
Well,
I hated his hairline too, and I didn't complain about that. Damn. So
we got people in the comments.
Not even Akosua.
You know who that is?
Kosi. That's Kosi.
Kosi. Sorry if I mispronounced that. Thank you for listening, Kosi.
Hi, Kosi girl.
That's because most men say they don't want a relationship, and we should be able to accept that. Like, women have a hard time, like, he don't want a relationship. That is period. I'm not finna change him. That's what it is.
But that's not how women think.
No, it's not. And even if you think that you think in the right way, you still, in the back of your mind, are trying to change his mind.
Right.
It's just facts.
Girls be like, oh, because my pussy this, or because I could do this for him. And it's like,
everybody
no,
got a vagina.
But everybody don't have good vagina.
Hey, look, we can't speak on that, man. Right.
It's not everybody doesn't have good vagina. I'm sorry.
I wouldn't know. I wouldn't know.
Willis said, shout out to Willis.
Willis.
What
you talking about, Willis?
Don't do that. He probably been hearing that all his life and he hate it. Boundaries are key. Niggas be saying shit in the beginning, but don't follow through on the boundaries. Yes, I respect niggas that say up front, like, I don't want a relationship. Or when you get to that point, they say, I don't want a relationship. But for the niggas that be like, let's see where this goes.
I mean, you never know where it can go, though.
That's true.
You never know.
But niggas know off top. Niggas know off top when they meet a woman. Who, like, what they want her to be in their life.
Very true.
That's true.
Yeah.
But my thing is, you never know. Somebody can be completely different from where you meet them, like, one time at this such and such bar or whatever, or this gathering, whatever you want to say. You meet them there, and then you meet them, you hang out with them by themselves.
There. You still got to figure it out.
Yeah.
Still trying to figure it out. They kind of different. Or you kind of, like, when you really get to talk to somebody, you be like, I guess I'm not really feeling like that.
Or see them without their makeup. Sometimes that's scary.
They be out here catfishing, huh?
Man,
Kosi says a lot of relationships start off as friendships, which is good, but that's a form of a relationship. So it's unfair when they say they don't want a relationship and try to flip it as just being friends.
See, to me, and then that's where it really, for me, it depends on the person. Cause like Kosi said, like, relationships you start off as friendships. So like, that's where, like, the whole talking and dating is like similar, because when you're talking or dating somebody, you know, you're hanging out leads to a friendship, some type of bond. So
I do feel like it's a case by case thing, for sure.
It is. It's for sure case by case.
But niggas still be playing games.
No, I mean, that's a fact too. That's definitely a fact. Because
females play games too.
And that's a fact too. Like, it's games all around.
Me personally, I think every girl has a backup dude, or they have somebody that they can hit up.
That's an insecurity for you. Every girl does not have a backup dude.
Yeah, okay. Honestly.
Man, I'm trying to tell you.
That's what people think, but honestly, like.
So you telling me y'all can't hit up somebody on y'all phone right now and they be like, come through?
Well, yeah, but like,
that's not
somebody that you
dude.
Want. That's not a backup dude. That's just like any nigga. But like, somebody that you actually
any nigga
like.
Doing that? That's even more. Now. You just
had no tool. If you hit any nigga up and say, come through.
That's not true. Some niggas gonna be like, nah, not tonight. Maybe another day. Some
nigga. What? What nigga?
Yeah.
Well, let me probably know. Your case, huh?
Your case.
She like, nigga, if I hit you up, you already know the deal.
Even have niggas in my phone to hit up, but I'm just saying, like, I do. I don't feel like girls have backup niggas. That's not like a.
Because you, would you. Well, that's. So that depends on, like, the mood, I guess. So, like, backup niggas, as in, like, y'all thinking on, like, a relationship bond, like, a deeper bond. He's on thinking, like.
A nigga you can hit up and like, you want
to do sex
or just hang out
to do sex
to do sex
to do sex. You money old ass lady.
To do sex. I'm hitting you up to do sex.
I don't like saying have sex because it sounds. I don't know. I don't like how it sounds.
You say smang. Smang is an old term.
Smang.
Smash and bang. Remember that, Joan?
Let me smack it, girl.
They rock with that one.
How you like them eggs?
Anybody else
fried
in the comments?
Fertilized. That is funny.
Seen what?
Everybody's laughing at you. Somebody said to do
shout
sex.
Out to Zed. Skrr, skrr.
Hey,
shout
out
to Zed. Zed, what do you guys? Oh, folks definitely seem to miss the fact that a friendship is a relationship.
That's a fact. That is a big fact.
Yeah.
It is. No, for real. A friendship is a relationship.
So to get off this subject, because we can disagree and agree to disagree on this thing.
So you're on the...
More of the story. Moral of the story. Niggas need to be honest up front, and females need to understand the honesty and stop trying to make it something else.
So word. Niggas not really wrong in conclusion, right?
We not in conclusion yet. We got some rounds of discussion.
Right. We got some rounds of discussion for sure.
I think that's why people are best friends for a reason.
Yeah.
So on a guy versus a girl, right? Mm-hmm. Who do you think is more invested into the relationship sooner, whether it be a friendship or a relationship?
It depends.
Girls. Well, it really depends because niggas will surprise you.
Yeah, that's too hard because you only can speak for yourself. That's how I feel about it. You only can speak for yourself.
I really
on a general basis, who do you think, or do you still think it's like a case by case thing?
That's how I view stuff. For me, relationships and relations, all that, I view on a case by case basis. Like, maybe that's just me, but because everybody, you treat everybody differently. Yeah, and like, even if you dogging somebody and you dogging the next person, you still treating each of those individuals some kind of different. So everybody's different. So it varies. Like,
yeah, because I mean, just as much as men be doing stupid shit, women be doing stupid shit too.
Yeah, so like you never know, because like
that's too hard. You only can speak for yourself, I think, on that subject.
Because you could personally, you could be dating somebody, and then like with this girl, okay, I really like her a lot, but she's not really on me. But then another girl, like, I ain't really feeling her, but she's on me a lot. So it just really depends on the person.
True love, that's what it is.
I can agree with that because I've had some dudes that have like literally just like not wanted to leave me alone. It's fucking creepy.
Annoyed the shit out of you.
Like they just be too invested. Like, oh, why you don't tell me you love me? Like, nigga, because I just started to be in like with you, my nigga. Like, goddamn.
Are you in a relationship?
Yeah.
Oh man, I know he is a tough guy. Well,
he is.
You are something else, girl.
I'm very easy.
She's different than she is.
No.
Are you fronting?
Nah, she love cuz, but
she love cuz.
She love cuz. She not one of those.
Nah, she love cuz.
I'm not like a
she do be talking that shit to him.
I'm not like I don't talk shit to him. I don't disrespect him. I mean, but
that's good.
But I'm also not like,
that's a start.
I don't know. For me, it was different because our relationship started off very like nonchalant. Like I'm not like a needy. Let me be up under. Let's hold hands. Like I don't like touchy. I don't like
really affectionate like that.
I don't like that. Like I don't like that. Like, oh, hold my hand while we walk to the same fucking place that we're walking to. Like I'm grown. I know where to walk. Like, I don't like holding hands.
I'd be like, why don't you want to hold
hands? Yeah, no, I don't like PDA and, like, all of that stuff. Like, that's just not my thing.
I'm happy with that, too.
If we driving in the car and your hand is not on my thigh, it's a problem.
Well, see, that's not me.
I mean, hand on the thigh do feel good.
I'm trying to drive the damn car.
That part, too.
Like, not with
Moni will tell you.
What if I got to turn left?
Moni will tell you, like, anybody hanging out with me and my boyfriend, like, you will never feel like a third wheel. No. Like, some people, sometimes they don't even know that we're together. Like, girls have literally come up to him trying to talk to him, and he'll just be having a conversation. Like, yeah, my girl right there. And they be looking like, oh.
That's because y'all have a great friendship, too.
Yeah, that's dope. That's
y'all
have a great friendship.
Shit like that, that's hard.
So it's just like, I don't do all that mushy, ooh, love me, kiss me, hug me, hold my hand. Like, no.
Yeah, I'm half and half with that.
It depends. It depends how the girl is. If she wants it, then gotta do it, I guess. Gotta do it.
If she's worth it, then you'll do it.
Okay, let's not say if she's worth it.
She's a fairy tale. Money low key trying to throw shots. Yeah. Like, oh, wait, if she's worth it.
Is that not logical? Like, if he feels like she's worth it, then he'll do it.
Yeah, but my thing is, if that's not who I'm really, if that's not who I am,
it's gonna break you eventually.
Okay.
Like, it's gonna break you.
Oh, Lord.
Zeddy is on y'all side. He says he feel y'all. He's heard plenty of women that have backup. Hashtag to do sex.
I don't know who that is, but I fuck with you.
I rock with the boy.
Only thing I pick up is my nudes and game data.
Oh my god!
Shout out to Zed, always supporting.
Right, Kosi said men have backups too. They just don't tell their backups that they're backups.
Oh, yes. Men got hella. They're not even backups. They just
Women are women. I don't know what it is, but women, when women know you're in a relationship, they don't give a damn. So that's on y'all,
that's
really.
That's wild.
It depends on how you look.
That's on women, I think.
What?
Women, y'all be wilding.
You said it what?
Depends on how you look. If you, because like, well, I'm piggybacking off of him. Mm-hmm. Him saying.
What depends on how you look? I think I may have missed something.
You definitely did.
Okay.
Because he was just saying how when you, as a guy in a relationship, you can get a lot of chicks. They just attract to you. But I'm like, it depends on how you look. Because just because you have a girlfriend don't mean, I want you because you have a girlfriend.
Some girls will want you more.
No, yeah, we know that.
Yeah, disrespectful.
But I'm just saying, depending on how you look, though.
Yeah, they
it's like, I mean, you got a girlfriend. Oh, you look even better now.
Oh, do your girlfriend do you like this? I could just imagine.
Why are people?
It's okay.
It's some wild ones. I am telling y'all.
His girlfriend can sock your ass in the face too.
Yep.
But I don't think dudes be having backups.
You don't think dudes be having backups? Like, do you know how many guys I have that are like guy friends that I have that they have hella backups?
Like backup girls?
Because it's just like when they girl tripping, they hit up the next bitch like, come suck my dick real quick. This bitch tripping. And they come do it.
Suck my dick real quick.
Damn.
Man, that's what tripping. I mean.
I wish a nigga
again,
would.
I can't speak for everybody. I can speak for myself. Oh, that's just, I don't want to have karma having, like that. That's a terrible karma.
I can see if you out here just dating and wilding and. Yeah, that's just how niggas are.
And there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, if you're young and you're not in a relationship and you just fucking bitches, then that's your prerogative. But
hey, I'm working on me. All right, I'm working on me. I'm single, by the way.
You
ladies.
Ain't working on yourself if you fucking bitches. I'm sorry.
I never
can't
said I was.
Yourself.
You can be working on yourself.
No, you cannot.
Females right say it all the time. I don't want to do this
you
right
taking,
now. I'm
you
on
taking spirits with you. No.
Oh yeah, you can't. Spirits.
You transferring like spirits and stuff. Yeah. When you doing stuff.
Please
like
go
that.
Deeper into that, please.
So is it a bad spirit or a good spirit?
It whatever depends. Fucking spirit that's person
gotta,
got.
That's why you got to know who you fucking.
Oh well,
you that's transfer spirits. Of energy.
Don't fuck nobody. I've seen that tweet the other day. Don't fuck nobody that you wouldn't take life advice from.
All right, don't.
That's deep. Niggas are not thinking about life advice when I want to hit something. Like, I don't give a damn what you think about life. Like,
wait,
so y'all just be fucking anybody?
No,
that's
no,
not what
we're
said,
not. That's not what we think. We can give it up. That's not what we're
not
saying.
Going to. We're not going to that deep.
We're not going to that deep of a level. Like mentally at the time, like
it's just I'm about to fuck her and yeah.
Hey, can't man, touch that thick booty. Women, they are dangerous.
But like, I've never heard that though. Like, I know about transferring energy and stuff like that, but as far as like the whole soul and.
I agree with it.
Yeah, I'm not too deep into that one.
I believe in transferring energy.
Where does Willis come from with this question? You say you don't believe in that?
That's not what I said.
Oh, sorry. Where do Willis come from with this question? So, Kirsten, do you don't believe in the whole phase? Ooh, girl.
Yes, I believe in a whole phase. I ain't never had one, but I believe in it.
Okay. How's it a phase? I feel like that's just like
okay, so because this is the thing,
they still be doing.
They call
it
no.
Man.
They call. I do feel like some girls like once a hoe, always a hoe.
Yeah, college.
I do feel that way. Once a hoe, always a hoe. But like, no, I mean like a like Drea.
Drea's not a hoe no more. Shout out to Drea. I love her. She's amazing. I would marry her.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah.
Nah, it's crazy because I wasn't on the Drea wagon until I seen her in person. I was like, damn.
Her body probably
she looks like a bird. She's not even a
child. I mean, I felt the same way until I seen her in person. I was like, damn.
Drea looks
and her
beautiful.
Toes is like this. They like throwing up signs.
How you
like,
know her? Oh,
well,
yeah.
I've seen
her
toes,
before.
But that body,
you know
right?
Who I seen in person? Brittany Renner.
That body, right?
I've seen her in person. She weird right now, but her booty is like wow.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
No, but I do believe, Willis, to answer your question, I do believe in the whole phase. I know a lot of people that have gone through the whole phase, and sometimes they need to do that to find themselves. Sometimes.
Yeah, college is definitely. Yeah, I feel like that's when everybody uses college as like their exodus.
Like, let me just get all this wild shit out.
That's a whole other level of wild story.
Yeah.
Jackie said, dang, y'all got some memories. Y'all y'all all took a breath and was like, yeah, college.
Nah, well, not Jackie, even like that.
Wait.
I didn't even go Jackie said, I party there.
Jackie, we have Jackie in the comments. You guys make sure to check out Jackie's show every Friday at 7:30, Ladies Night. That should be popping.
What y'all be talking about on Ladies Night, Jackie?
They be talking about everything. Jackie said, wait, so I can't have a booty call while I date?
Yeah, you can.
See, that's you're why not girls be having backups.
And that's what we talking about.
I didn't say that girls don't have backups. I'm just saying guys have backups more than girls.
I don't know about more than girls.
No, yeah. Y'all, no, the difference is y'all got backups that y'all could be in a whole relationship with.
What do you think girls have?
Talking about, oh, you want to, because niggas be having secret families.
If she's just dating, she can have a backup because she's not in a committed relationship.
I'm telling y'all, in LA, the women outweigh the men by a lot. It's crazy. Like,
transplants and everything now.
Niggas don't be shit. So that's we don't really have as many options as men do.
Gay.
Huh?
Girls. I said that's why that's why women just start being gay.
Nah, that ain't.
Yes, it is.
You can't really blame it on us being overly populated.
Like, I'm not blaming it on y'all. Yeah. I'm not blaming anything.
But that's, yeah, like, it's just the numbers.
Yeah, we all numbered.
It's not our fault.
It's a lot of comments. Should we?
I know. Yeah. Let me acknowledge them really quick. So we have Kosi.
Shout out to Kosi.
How does one get from being a booty call and being the one they date? Oh, that's a question for y'all.
Oh, for us?
Yeah. You can go on. You could get this one, Keith.
From a booty call to a date.
Booty call. You start at the bottom. Dog.
It's at the bottom.
Not necessarily. Not necessarily.
It depends. You just want to just keep that one freak, really. You just want to keep a freak.
So it ain't no coming out of that.
You can. I mean,
just
but
not with you.
Hashtag keep a freak.
Nah, not just with me. Nah, I don't.
We need
I
to start saving these hashtags. Yeah,
that's a low-key hard hashtag, Key.
Hashtag keep a freak.
I'm gonna put it in the chat.
I don't know. Honestly, I think it depends on the girl. Like, say we go out to eat or we go out to a movie, whatever, et cetera, all that. But, and then we go back to my crib and we get it in. What do we need to go out again for if we gonna go to the
so if she starts off as a booty call, you've already lost respect.
No, I don't lose respect for you because of that. I don't lose no respect for no one like that.
Yeah, nah.
Then what do you lose?
Lose what?
Moni, like, cut the bullshit. So what do you lose?
Okay, you don't lose respect for her, but you don't feel like she's worthy of a date anymore.
No, I'm just saying we might as well just go to what we want to really get into. You know what I'm saying?
You just took on a date so you could fuck her.
No, I did not. I never go on a date and expect to. I never do. Especially if it's my first time with somebody, I never expect it.
I feel like you're lying.
Damn. A nigga can't be his own person.
Montoya, is he lying? Is Montoya still listening? I need Montoya to be Montoya. Verifying these lies.
Montoya's a liar.
Damn, that's crazy. I can't even be my own person.
Yeah, he might be a little bit of a fibber.
Like, nobody believes that? Really? Damn, yeah.
How about you? Is there a way of coming out of booty call to a date?
Well, I feel like in some situations, maybe, like, it can just, like, if it's a booty call, so it's like, damn, that shit was fire. Like, I want more. And then more could lead. No, you asking my.
I'm listening to
and
you.
And then more could lead to, like, damn. I don't want nobody else to have it. And then it's like, damn, do I like her? Do you? And then it just goes from there.
Do y'all believe I can find love the first night?
No.
Yeah,
I think exactly. You can. I think no. It happens for some people.
You said love on first sight.
Love
at first sight.
All right, let me say,
like on a first date.
If you hit the first time, then you think you can be in a relationship with them.
No,
the first night.
I feel like you still.
Yeah.
I mean, eventually you can grow with them.
I know some people that's like true.
Yeah,
and they still together married. Hell, them niggas married.
Yeah, so booty call from dating to marriage. It's happening.
So, Kosi, I'm going to answer. I do feel like, even though I know a lot of guys will probably say no, because I've actually heard a lot of guys say that they lose respect for, like, their booty call because it's like they've been in that position for so long. But I feel like a lot of guys end up liking I feel like a lot of girls end up liking, I mean, a lot of guys end up liking the booty call because it's like, it's the booty call and y'all have late night conversations. Like y'all talk, like the booty call be knowing more shit than the fucking girl that you're dating, because the girl that you're dating, because you spend so much time with that person, she get on your fucking nerves.
I can end up going to sleep
after. But then you with the booty call, y'all end up having conversations.
True.
If I have a booty call, I'm pretty sure she's going to spend the night and we might grab some food in the morning.
See, yeah, y'all having conversations. Exactly. Like I said,
I'm probably going to want to hit in the morning, too.
Oh, my God. Can I hit it in the morning?
And that's where the booty call that you be like, damn, it was fire. It leads to, like my man said, I think I want to hit in the morning. Please, go ahead. Then hit in the morning, we going to get breakfast. And then now all of a sudden, we talking every day.
Or I might not see you in another week. And then the same shit happened again.
Oh, my gosh. Shout out to Jazz. She's and in the comments. Jazz, her show is every Sunday at, no, sorry, every Saturday at 10 a.m. It's called The Initiative. She said, I had some backups back in my day. Leave it to Jazz. Back in my
day. You got your own homies.
She's like 23.
Your own homies is saying they got backups.
Your own homies, Keyshawn is saying that you a lie.
Oh yeah, Montoya said y'all lying.
And y'all, he said you're not expecting to hit, but you hoping to hit.
EP says, shout out to EP.
Boy, wait a minute, did you say wholesome girls are boring, Key?
Shout out to EP.
You not wholesome.
Who, me?
No, you not wholesome.
I'm wholesome enough, bitch. And I'm not boring.
That statement right there, I'm wholesome enough, bitch.
I'm gonna put that on a shirt. Oh my god, let me make
that's low key hard. Like
that hashtag. I'm wholesome enough, bitch. I'm about to
hashtag.
Keep
a freak.
EP says, if I still want to hang out after the booty call, then you have a chance.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Zed said, hella first nighters married. True.
Shout out to everybody in the comments answering her questions.
He said that she's not a booty call. She's
clapping cheeks keep you meek. What the fuck?
Niggas in here spitting their bars
that
right
is
now.
So funny.
Hey, I'm loving it.
Oh my god.
Booty call sneak up on you and be the one.
Like I said,
I'm dead.
Be the booty call. You like, yo, this shit fire. Now we hit it.
That is funny as hell.
Okay, y'all. So we're gonna get into our trending topics. Our trending topic hashtag this week is niggas wildin' online, because niggas have been wildin' this week.
Oh, Lord.
So, first of all, Jill Scott.
Hey, why we got to go right into that? I was just talking about that earlier.
With the got.
Hey. Give me the Jill Scott.
I didn't watch the whole video. It was making me uncomfortable.
Hey, give me the Jill Scott.
It makes you uncomfortable? You've never watched videos to learn how to, like, suck dick?
All right, you over here learning, huh?
No, it just made me uncomfortable to see Jill Scott like that, because she's like auntie.
Nah, I heard she a freak.
Her music, oh.
I said,
Jill Scott always been a little thicker. Thicker.
I heard she a freak with her music.
Yeah, I would say her music.
She be doing that stuff doing her shows. She be humping stuff. I be like,
really?
Girl, what's really going
See,
on?
See, I ain't know all that. Mm-hmm. But
what's crazy about that video, I thought she was just singing, and then I actually watched the video. She over there, wow.
I haven't seen the whole thing. I need to watch it.
Man. She. What I took from that video was that she likes to get sprayed. Because that's mainly what I took from that video, because I was like,
real though,
oh wow, I didn't expect that part. Like I get the whole other part, because I'm like, okay, yeah, she getting that shit, but the end, I was like, oh, that's the part that shocked me, because I'm like, I didn't know she was like that. Like
she went for the fake
balls. That's when I was like, oh, okay, but the ending really was like, oh,
I heard it's
okay,
good for
Jill.
Yeah. I mean, it depends what the nigga eating and all that type
ever,
of stuff.
If
though.
It ever gets on you and then, like, it's, like, wiped off, it's, like, really soft. Yeah, like, your skin is, like, really soft. So I can imagine it being, like,
so
really
it's, like,
soft.
Coconut oil.
Okay.
It's still
harsh. I got a lot of that in my hand.
Nigga, silly. All
right, I got a question for that.
Yeah.
Do y'all like when a dude comes on you? Or no?
Why are we asking this question?
Somebody brought it up.
This is not after hours.
It gotta be after hours.
Was it me? I feel like I segued into that.
Yeah. I answered.
We pulled
and
up
that's
the Jill
answer.
Scott.
That's my answer. I answered.
Oh.
Just shook her head. Let the people wonder if you said yes or no.
People in the comments, does Kirsten like to get nutted on? Yes or no?
Jill Scott hit the people with the double Glock 3000. Nobody expected this. Like, Jill Scott was wilding this morning.
She made everybody come out now. Oh, I didn't even get to this part.
Yeah,
some girl
said the Kim Kardashian.
Some girl said make your skin feel good. Well, we know you freaky too.
Somebody said that?
Let me see who said
Edacia.
That.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
Yeah, she wildin'.
Yeah.
Oh.
Good shit, Jill Scott.
Good shit.
Oh, okay. That's this.
Yeah, I told you that ending was shocking. That was a plot twist.
No, but I've talked to people that like met her in person and they were like, because you know she's bigger. They're like, she got sex appeal, like off top. Well, it's her confidence.
I think her titties make her look bigger than what she really is.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, she's not really that big. Chris. I could. Yeah. Yeah. What are y'all laughing at over there?
Yeah. Somebody in the comments going ham on me.
Shane answered.
I answered.
I didn't even know Chris was listening. He want to chime in on that part.
Of course, because Chris like nutting on bitches' faces. That's why.
Damn.
Oh, I'll never forget that. Yeah, I netted on a bitch. I would never expect.
I literally had a mild heart attack when he said that.
Stop stalling and answer the question. Everybody want to know.
I answered the damn question.
What's the question?
Y'all should have been listening.
What she like to get sprayed on?
Because I answered.
On your face?
Anywhere.
Damn.
What did you say? What did you
All right,
say?
Look.
To anywhere.
If you guys would like to know the answer, make sure that you follow us, and I don't know what the fuck.
I mean, they're not going to answer, but.
I answered the question, bruh.
Anyways, so.
What's the next trending topic?
You ain't say shit, Shane. Okay. Why are you so mad?
Jill Scott made this make a quick right real quick.
Okay, nigger fishing. Do you guys follow Vince Staples?
Yeah, that's the homie.
That's the homie?
Chris said you got to answer the question. Sorry, before we talk about nigger fishing. Uh-huh. Chris said, answer the question, Moni. For you, not for me.
Me?
Mm-hmm. Answer the question. Do you like spray? Do you like
what?
Spray?
I don't know what that is. Nigger fishing.
It's when a man ejaculates on your face.
No, I don't. No,
wait,
I don't.
Who didn't know what spray meant?
Moni tried to say that she didn't know what it meant.
Man.
No, I don't.
No, like you don't know what black. It means, or no, you don't like,
like
it?
You don't know slang. Like.
No, I don't like that.
Great.
Said, oh.
That's crazy, Shana. You wild.
Me? What the fuck did I do? What did I do?
What did you do?
She never answered. She just gave like a half smile and was like, okay. Next question.
Sheesh.
Anyway, what do you guys think about nigger fishing?
I think it's ridiculous.
It's very ridiculous.
I didn't know what it was. It's crazy because, like, even before Vince Staples hopped on it, mm-hmm. I saw it, like, the day before. Mm-hmm. And I was still trying to figure out, like, wait, what? And then I, like, looked it up, and I'm like, people are weird. Simple as that.
For people that don't know, this is Vince Staples' definition. He said, nigger fishing is when Caucasians are posing as black and beautiful on social media. And he says, if we catch you in the streets nigger fishing, we will jump you and take your social. So basically, mm-hmm. when y'all see these girls, these bloggers.
Let's enlighten Keith because he's confused. So
nigger fishing?
Yeah, so Keith, there were these white girls. I'll show you the pictures.
Yeah.
White girls who did their makeup to look like black girls and even making their hair like look like natural curly.
Making
like
it, hair. Yeah. Like doing braid outs girls. To look real thick.
Yeah.
To appear like mixed or racially black. Racially ambiguous black.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So.
Basically blackface.
Yeah, basically blackface.
Yeah.
On social
and they would
media.
Like delete their pictures, their old white pictures, and be like, this is like.
See, and I didn't go that deep
but
into
they'd be
it,
like
but
pale, like that poster. But then they like.
Like when black girls straighten their hair? Oh my
like
God.
They be from Europe.
Do black girls wear fucking powder makeup?
Yeah.
No, not since Fenty came out.
Exactly. You
Fenty
right.
came out 2015.
Yep.
Color match. There was no makeup to color match our skin.
No, I'm hey, hold on, baby. I'm with the Fenty, okay? I'm just saying.
That ain't no problem.
I'm just saying. I'm just saying. Y'all was using powder
and
makeup.
No, y'all, I don't even wear makeup.
Not y'all, okay.
You're actually women. Supposed to use setting powder if we want to keep it real. It's just that you have to use the expensive one.
Man, she be
so that when you
line.
Take pictures, it doesn't do a flashback. So you have to use a higher-end brand.
I'm not crazy. You probably see me crazy one time in your life.
That's enough. I don't need to see it two times. One is enough.
And I don't even think I was crazy that time.
What time?
I never seen it once, but I don't want to.
But he said I'm crazy, so that means he didn't see something.
What you do that was crazy?
I don't know. What did I do?
Go off on people. You know, that's the norm.
You see me go off on somebody?
Yeah, I have.
Was it you?
Nah, sweetie. Yeah,
oh.
Yeah.
Anyways. Yeah. It's wild out here with people.
Nigger fishing is crazy.
People is crazy.
Yeah, I don't know nothing about that.
Shit weird, though.
That's why I said the other day on
Yeah, they
Insta
hella
story.
Fucking weird. Like,
it's great to be black. It's great to be black. Like, we were blessed to be born this way.
Yeah. And everybody wants to be like us, so it's time to be us. And I'm always going to say that and stick to that.
Yeah.
You said what?
Everybody wants to be us until it's time to be us.
Yeah.
Period.
Oh,
okay.
Last, period with a T. Sure, no,
you're talking about,
Last trending topic. I can't see. I need some glasses.
You just get contacts. Shout out to all the contact wearers out there. Everybody with bad vision. All my people in the struggle. That negative vision.
Kirk Franklin.
Okay. I feel you, man.
So,
we out here.
I know y'all seen this video. Maybe not you changed.
Nah, I ain't see that video. Oh, I did see this video.
Okay, listen to this, girl.
Don't let these niggas play y'all. Don't let these niggas tell you he gonna take you on a date, and then when it's time to pay, nigga wanna pull out a fucking credit card like he a broke-ass nigga. Don't take me on no date if you don't got your own cash, if you don't got your own debit card. Don't take me on no fucking date. That ain't taking me on no date pulling out your fucking credit card. You taking me on a date with the fucking government because you paying the damn government back for taking me on a damn date. So that means you ain't never take me on a date, so that means you owe me another fucking date, nigga.
Not even matter. That just means she only fuck with a certain type of guy. Scammers
just
and hood
means
niggas.
She a that's stupid
fucking,
ass bitch.
That's
she
fucking
sounds
wild.
Like, that's it.
Basically, what it was.
No, I get it.
This girl
it's
was
wild.
Saying, like, if you take me on a
you know
date
who that
and
is,
you pay
right?
my credit card,
who is
you
that?
Full of shit.
That's one of the sisters that came out with that. Remember, fuck that dumbass popular song that went like crazy on social media. Like,
I'm a boss ass
last.
Bitch.
No, not that one. It was the.
I for sure thought of that one too.
It was the shit. Fuck. I'm gonna think. I'm gonna think about it. No, you know for
I
sure.
I probably
what
would.
It is.
What?
See, this is why we tell y'all to come over. I can't be mad at us. We just tell y'all to come over.
Oh yeah, you did say that. I did. No,
I've
but
definitely seen this video.
No, it's like.
What's her name again?
That's just crazy.
I don't know her name.
All I'll say about this is that Twitter just makes everything hard now.
Don't let these niggas play y'all.
Don't let these niggas play.
You can't like fall into the rules of Twitter.
Superstar something.
Twitter rules are all people making up their own rules. Like with the Twitter dates and shit. You can't fall into that. You just gotta look at that shit as fucking comedy. Because this shit is pure comedy.
I mean, think she's a troll. Like
that, exactly.
Who is staring that hard to know if it's a credit card or a debit card?
I didn't even think about it that way. But like, definitely.
Like my thing is, how would you even know?
Yeah.
Like
how could you know the difference between those two?
That's
stupid.
Right.
And
like,
then, but the
looking,
thing is,
you're already looking too hard.
The whole problem, which is weird, is the fact that you're not paying for nothing. Like you on a date. First off, y'all talk about, you complain about a guy taking you on a date. Now my guy's taking you on a date. Now that it's a credit card, it's a problem. This is what we saying, like with the date norms, we all fucked up.
I
now.
Remember now, Taylor Girls. They're part of the Taylor Girls. Remember that song that went crazy? Everybody was doing the wedgie and the booty and the Still Her Man challenge.
Never heard of that.
No.
You never heard of the Still Her Man challenge?
Hell no.
No.
That was all over Instagram.
I need some footage and some videos
with
and clips.
It was from 2013. No. It was like something. Still Her Man. Still Him. Or something like that.
I've never
you
heard
know
of that.
What? Hold on.
My nigga, I've never heard of
I'm
that.
I'm going to play it right now so you know what I'm talking about.
This
Chris
shit.
Said the woman in the video is such a fucking idiot. Broke niggas don't have credit cards. Because I know when I didn't have no credit, no fucking credit card.
You know
people was
damn, I didn't even think of it that way. Shout out to you in the comments. Because you definitely have to have some type of money to even get credit.
Like,
so I didn't even think of it that way.
Oh, I've heard this.
I've never heard this.
I try to stay away from music like this.
You've heard this song. Because you've seen people dance to it.
I got to see. Let me see. Is there a dance to it?
It's like, it used to be a Vine.
Yeah.
I've never heard this in my life.
Well, if she made or was a part of the making of this song, then I fully understand why she's views life this way.
First of all, like I said earlier, I don't like rat talk. All that, if this motherfucker did it, I don't like fucking talking like that. That shit irritating as fuck. Like, bitch, you get your ass up. Do you have a credit card, bitch? No. You probably living off of your little Instagram money with no fucking credit, so shut the fuck up.
Oh, I don't like loud girls in general.
That part.
What about if they had an EBT card? Would that be a deal breaker?
No, put me on your EBT, nigga.
EBT is, you get a lot of groceries. That's
exactly. How much you get in this? That's about
like, I don't think no person in their right mind is going to be like, damn, you get free money for groceries? I can't fuck with you, like.
Yeah, first of all, who am I to be like, I'm not fucking rich, my damn
You say you're not fucking right. with somebody if they get free groceries?
He said who in their right mind.
No, I said who in their right mind would be like.
You about to snap on you.
Once again, I wish y'all could see the look she's been, like, when she give me that quick look to the left.
I'm low-key jealous of people that get free-ass groceries.
I feel that.
Yeah, it is.
Like, I get real jealous because it's like, I can't. And that shit whack. Like, they don't know my struggle. They don't even take the time to listen
really
to my struggle.
It's really hard to get free groceries because I remember when I was unemployed at the beginning of this year, mm-hmm. they only gave me like $15 on my ABT card. I'm like, the hell?
I would love to.
You might as well kept the whole thing and give me $15.
Like, you could buy like 20 packs of noodles with that. That's
it's
it.
Like,
that's
I don't care it. How much money I make. I still want free ass groceries. I just went on to the grocery store on Saturday. I spent $134.
Yes. I spent $45.
When I used to grocery shop.
The only thing, luckily, my godson's mom gave me her EBT card, and I used $50 of her EBT, and then I spent the rest. But it's just like, damn, like, I shouldn't have to. Food should be free.
Anybody in the comments, you got EBTs and you want to rock with me, please send them my way.
I didn't realize how expensive groceries were until I got to college. Man. And that's when I was like, this shit is ridiculous. Start looking at my mom completely different. Because I used to try to only spend like 70 max when I was shopping for groceries. Like,
ain't no way.
And that shit's hard.
Let me tell everybody something that y'all probably don't know. Everybody should know that Walmart has groceries. If you shop at Walmart for groceries, they have a scan bar at the bottom of the receipt. If you scan, if you download the Walmart app and scan the bottom of the receipt, you get money back for any item that's cheaper in any other store in the local area. Nice.
Cause this is a grocery store, Walmart, up the street from my house.
Yep, and literally I one time, like it literally took me like maybe like 2.5-3 months. I had like $85 on my shit, and
damn.
I got to yes.
And you could use that $85 at Walmart
to purchase. Yeah, so you get
but can't
the actual
use that
money back.
Any Walmart though.
Any Walmart.
Oh, what? Because Walmart, you know, Walmart's the one stop. So
no, you can use it at any Walmart. Because at first less, I was like, homie, this is stupid. Like, I'm probably never going to save. But it's like the larger your purchases are, like when you go shopping, you scan, they find stuff cheaper at like Food for Less sometimes,
shout
Target, whatever the case.
Shouts out to Food for Less.
And you get that money back. Sometimes I hate when they see me at Ego talking about our prices won. And I'd be like, fuck you. I didn't want your prices to win. I wanted some money back. But sometimes you get like $5 here back, $6 here. And that mess add up. And then when you having a hard time, you need groceries, you could just go scan your phone. You got money.
If you ever want to get cheap liquor, Superior be having the low prices.
Shout out Superior.
I went to Superior for the first time.
Don't buy meat from Superior.
I'm not buying no meat. But y'all need to get the little Mexican sodas. That shit bomb. I forgot what it's called, but it's so good. I don't know what it's called, but it's in a little bottle.
Why
like
you had to put an accent when you said it? Why everybody? Every time somebody says Spanish word, they got to just change their voice and everything.
Because we all speak Spanish.
Because that's how we are as black people.
We went to a foreign language magnet high school. Did y'all know it was like called Gardena Foreign Language Academy or something?
I knew
like
because
that.
I never knew that.
I knew because my dad was trying to get me into Narbonne magnet. Uh-huh. And then in looking at that, I saw Gardena was a magnet. I'm like, Gardena is a magnet?
Yeah, I was in.
You went to Narbonne?
She did.
Oh, yeah. What year did you graduate?
09.
Oh, you class 09? That's lit. Shouts out all. Hey, shouts out to class of 09.
Damn,
10
you
years.
You wasn't going to tell us nothing?
You
10 years
too?
Coming out.
Nah, I'm the youngest. I'm 10.
We out here, baby.
Oh, damn. Oh, yeah. You young. That's
shouts
why.
Out to 09.
Like shout out to 08. We didn't have no reunion because niggas.
I didn't graduate.
08 don't like each other.
I got kicked out.
You was fighting, huh?
I didn't start the fight, though.
You was fighting. Once I said we was fighting, you stopped.
Probably was fighting.
I went to Pedro.
I believe she was fighting.
You went to Pedro.
Pedro.
I didn't have nowhere else to go.
Every time I find out somebody went to Pedro, I'll just be like, how? How did you go to Pedro?
It was like jail.
They had a beautiful campus.
Pedro.
As a black
probably,
student
but as
Pedro,
a black man.
We had games there.
You went to Pedro?
No, I went to Gardena, but I used to cheer at the Pedro games.
I know that, but I'm just saying. That much.
No, I just thought it was a nice campus.
No, it's a nice campus, but
campus they trash.
Yeah, fuck Pedro. But like, nah, the farthest in the South Bay I would go would be like Carson, Narbonne, I would say, but. Pedro, Banning, I couldn't be black going to those schools.
Oh, you can't be black going to Banning. You have to get shot real quick, stabbed.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that's a fact, too.
Yeah, they don't fuck with
you. Only black people who survived at Banning all play football. That's about it. They get a pass.
They don't play no other sport but football.
Well, speaking of playing sports, let's play a game.
Hey, that's a very good segue.
I like that.
I rock with that. That was a good segue.
I got something for that.
That's how you got you. But I had a part of that. That was an assist.
We always here. You knew what I was doing.
Yeah, y'all should be there. Y'all done already had. How many episodes y'all done had? The chemistry should be there.
Y'all can't look at the screen. Y'all got to look that way. We going to play a little game.
Me too?
Yeah.
All of us?
Like, I'm going to play a little game.
Moni can't play because she did the damn song.
Yeah. Going along with the theme of You Not My Girl, we're going to play some You Not My Girl anthems. Okay.
How are we finna do the rules? Each person has to say what they think the next words is, and then we have to say
you
who got it right.
You gotta raise your hand. Actually,
if it's any neo soul songs,
okay. Whoever do it first.
Okay,
so we got Willis. Willis, you gotta say whoever raised their hand first. Who got the next lyrics? Yeah. Okay.
Right. No, you gotta name the song. And the artist.
Nobody knows the name of songs.
Don't try to cheat.
I'm not, okay. But I'm saying nobody knows. No, I didn't look. But I'm saying nobody knows the name of songs. Here, nobody knows the name of songs.
All right, the artist, or you can hum the tune. Fuck. You can name the artist, all the right. Song name, or you can hum the tune.
All right.
Okay? Okay, y'all ready? I'm going to play a few seconds, and you know, the first one to put their hand up gets to guess it. Okay? All right.
I might lose it.
I'm not.
Here we go.
Okay.
It's like playing musical chairs.
Oh, shit. Wait, hold on.
Oh, Lord.
The suspense is killing me.
I know it's giving me gas. Come on. What the
that
fuck?
That wasn't
okay,
enough.
Okay, y'all
that,
gotta be
right,
quiet.
Every song comes on like that.
Y'all gotta be quiet.
It's Ty Dolla $ign or something.
She ain't gonna tie me down.
Oh, you good.
New boy.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, nah, I didn't get that one. I needed to hear more. All right, how many seconds of the song are you playing?
Well, he got it.
She ain't gonna tie me down.
Hey, this was a theme song. Once again, shouts out to the year 2009.
You do the reject with my fingers.
That's crazy. I thought you were older than 09. Only because you hang out with them. I
thought you was at least 05.
So you was like, I use people by association.
Hang out with who?
He called you.
Hang out with who?
You said you thought she was 05 because she hang out with us?
No, he said 05. I said I thought she was 08 because...
You think I'm 05?
He was a joke.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm saying because she hang out with you and Jameez. Y'all both was 08, so I just by association.
Nah, she just the youngin'.
But that's how it be. Shouts out to all the youngin'.
All right, three more songs. Okay, y'all ready?
Yeah, let's get it.
Okay.
Oh, I ain't got it.
Damn.
It's Migos for sure.
Okay.
Boop. Boop. What's this shit called? Boop. Is she not a freak no more?
Yo, my man.
No,
is
freak.
Good.
No more. Oh, freak it is no called Freak.
But that's my card. It's crazy.
How the fuck
I need
are
more.
Y'all getting this, but
don't say y'all. It's only one person getting this shit, and it ain't me, because I need more of this shit. Yeah. Yeah.
She don't
be a freak no more. She don't want to be my little hoe. She don't want to do that shit no more. Why not? Because, bitch, she ain't no hoe.
Yeah.
I'm going to start freestyling, though.
Yeah.
I think I am freestyling.
Yeah.
The game just took a pause. Yeah. Let's see what they talking about, though. I'm done.
I'm done.
Okay.
Light bars.
Fuck you, Keyshawn.
All right, y'all gonna let Keyshawn take the whole game?
Well, I can't hear.
I'm
kind of
upsetting myself that I let that freestyle go. I was kind of getting off.
Pleasure Key.
Okay.
Pleasure Key.
Pleasure Key.
I'm part of Pre Ricky.
I let you down on the freestyle.
I must not listen. You know why? You know why I don't know these songs? Because all I listen is to fucking 90s music.
Yeah.
That's why I
should have threw some 90s.
Oh, you one of those? You listen? You for sure listen to neo soul, huh? If you only listen to 90s music, you for sure listen to neo soul. I know you do.
Okay, this is an easy one. Y'all ready?
Got it.
Oh, man. Fucking role models.
One time for my LA sisters.
She got this. It's wrong. I said it right. It's role models.
She don't want to be saved.
That's my point.
What's the name of the song?
It's role. No role models.
Nobody's going to guess the name.
I didn't even hear it that time.
I heard it. See, play some real music. You over playing.
She turned my mic down. I really didn't hear anything.
played that code. I got the instant. That's what I'm talking about. Wait, how is No Role Models a She Ain't My Girlfriend song?
Because it's a what?
Explain
what
me
say?
This.
It's probably the lyrics they got.
Wait,
down.
Ain't this the song where he'd be like,
"One time for my LA."
No, he say something about we kick her out, and I don't know.
Oh, okay, I know the bar. Yeah. All right, it passes because I got it bar. Right.
Okay,
thanks, Willis.
Okay, last one for the win.
Let's get it. All or nothing.
Make sure the writing don't come off. I spent a lot of work on that.
Oh,
no, I know that. It's.
I don't fuck with you, Big Sean.
Wait, her my neck. Wait, ain't How that Kid Ink? Kid Ink and Chris Brown, right?
Okay.
Kidding, Chris Brown.
Sing it.
My name. But you heard my name.
Okay.
Girl, I know you want to be my main chick.
Ooh.
How? Yeah, this song is a banger. Shout out to Kid Ink.
I get the topic.
Kid Ink has some bangers.
You can leave it up there, Willis.
Your name. But you heard my name. Girl, I you can't even get my thing. You heard my name.
Oh, this is a cool lyric.
Girl,
video.
I know you want to be my main chick.
Hey,
my main chick.
Hey, hey.
Y'all really into this, Jones.
Did anybody in the comments guess the songs accurately?
Nah, nobody did.
How did DJ Khaled say that shit? Accurate? Like, that nigga said accurate.
Pushed out what he said.
Pushed it out. So he.
Oh my God.
Accurate. Yes. I love that. I've been waiting for this moment just so I can say that.
Accurate.
You guys did a good job with our
Thank
game.
You. You know, we know music.
Okay.
Yeah. Shout out to the new boys.
Your partner don't know music.
Hey, the reason Shout why out. I thought of that yeah. is because I just watched that interview like on
man,
the way
you late,
here.
Man.
I know. Have you seen the Ben J interview?
Shout out to Ben J. He was hurt.
I really fuck with him because he told the whole story.
He did.
Who's Ben J?
From New Boys, the dark one.
Oh.
You still don't
I want to know more
You're
about
just gonna
this
Tinashe. Oh.
What happened?
Yeah, everybody
how
wanted some of that tea.
How the New Boys broke up and how he, like, killed somebody that was trying to rob his house. He was, like, crying.
You still don't know who it is.
Ben J?
I mean, yeah, but I'm just, like, I didn't, like, how'd they break up? Are you going to tell the story or no?
I mean, it's not really an interesting story.
It really ain't. Yeah. It's just some wild shit.
They got into a fight at the airport, and then that kind of like led up to them. And then the other guy was dating Tinashe, and she was in his ear like Yoko Ono, and was like,
she was like basically saying, "You're the better one.
Yeah,
you're
the better one.
You could do. You could be
and
on
he
your
murdered
own."
Somebody.
Yeah, it was like different situation.
Yeah, that's separate.
But those are like the highlights story. Of the interview. Though.
But he is like the definition of like LA accent, because he. You should watch the interview. It's a really good interview.
Okay.
Yeah.
She's not gonna watch it. She's lying to us right now in our face.
She didn't say she was gonna watch it, so
I didn't. Moni knows. Moni knows how I answer things. If that means yes or no.
Yes.
Well, I mean, y'all should. Y'all got chemistry by now.
The fans wanted to know the answer. That's why I said it for them.
I don't have no fans. Nobody likes me.
Shout out if you watched that interview.
Fans. What song is this? I like the beat.
It's a Travis Scott type beat.
Travis Scott type beat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I fuck with it.
Oh, my
God. I rock with Travis Scott type beats.
Produced
by Cody. Astroworld was hard. Shouts out to Cody for that Travis Scott type beat.
Yeah.
Beware copyright infringement, bro.
Oh, Lord. Anyways, let's get back into this topic.
Boom.
We touched on this earlier, but you jumped ahead because you was talking about this.
What
did
I do? Oh, shit. I'm always in trouble, man.
You ain't in trouble. I was just saying. Do you think that there are boundaries that should be set in place even though you're not in a relationship with a specific person?
That's where it gets tricky.
Yes.
But yeah, yes.
It's why true. And so number one, why should there be boundaries?
It's a respect thing. I think it's a respect thing. I think is we're talking and we're trying to build up to that point. We need to respect each other if we go out. Say we go out, you know, and we're talking to other people. Mm-hmm. But don't be doing no wild shit. Like, don't be kissing a nigga all in my, like, from my, if I can see you kissing him, doing something that.
Oh, you mean like.
So you don't care if she goes on another date, but if she like.
It depends where you at. It depends where you at in the dating stage. Because, I mean, you still, technically, you still can do whatever you please. But like I said, it's a respect thing. Don't have me out here looking stupid, basically. Yeah.
I'm definitely not finna fuck with you if we talking and I see you at the same event where I am kissing somebody, like. Yeah. You really don't give a fuck.
Yeah, definitely.
That's just the signs right there.
Yeah.
Disrespect. That's the biggest. I think it's just a respect thing. That's why boundaries have to be. But then again, that comes with communication.
Yeah.
Everything comes with communication. Because you're really going to talk to somebody in a certain capacity that you feel like that's the space they should be in. So, like, if you know you're talking to this person and it's like, I'm only with them for the sex, then you're, as a guy, you're probably going to keep it shallow. Like, you're not going to, like, oh, how was your day? What are you trying to do in life? You're not going to go that far. So, the combo is not going to be.
You know, that's how your day.
This nigga's a savage.
But, okay, right. Well, okay, I ain't trying to sound bad. But, like, that's, I'm just trying to say, like, get the idea of it. Like, that's the different boundary. Whereas if it's somebody where, you know, y'all are just talking and dating, but you kind of can see, like, you like this person, then you're going to have different conversations with them. And I feel like how the conversations go should not dictate, but it kind of show like a framework of what the situation is between us. Like, if we never talking about anything real or serious, then there should be no reason why you should have an idea or thought like we're together. And mm-hmm. if it's only, we're only linking up on like doing shallow shit. But I can see why, okay, if I'm talking to you and we're having like crazy combos, hanging out and shit like that.
And doing actual stuff.
Doing actual stuff, then I can see why it gets confusing.
Yeah.
And I mean, that shit happens, and it happens on both ends.
Me personally, if I talk to you or if I'm trying to hit or whatever you want to put in that perspective, mm-hmm. I want to know who you are.
That's true, too.
I can't just be smashing you and I don't know nothing about you. That's pointless. That's just... Unless it's like a one-night stand.
That's what I'm saying. You got to know.
Yeah,
you got to know who you're fucking.
Yeah, I think that's huge.
Yeah, especially when you're talking about, you know, transferring energies and stuff like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's real.
Like, even going on dates. If you do go on a date, I would say, just tell me.
You would want to know?
Yeah.
Because then...
Really? Cause
don't okay. have me looking stupid.
Am I saying...
I'm going to be pissed.
Oh, wow.
Hey, bro. That's the one that... So you saying that in the sense of, like... So I can know, like, where I need to take this, right?
Yeah.
All right, bet.
Now, if I'm...
I feel like that should be ambiguous. You should just assume that she's going on dates.
Nah, I'm, like I said, I don't know.
But then again, like you said, like, everybody's different. Yeah, like sure. There's some girls who, they don't do the whole super dating around, where you could be really the only guy they're really talking to seriously. And then there's the girls who, you know, they are really dating around, like, what dating is.
Yeah.
And they can be talking to multiple people, weighing options. That shit happens.
I think I agree with Keyshawn when he says that it depends. Only because if you are telling me that you want, like, okay, like, we're talking in order to see if we can build a relationship, there definitely needs to be boundaries. You can't fuck nobody. You can't kiss nobody. And, like, I need to know that you can at least have, like, a commitment just in this friendship part of the relationship.
But you can't get mad if they fuck somebody in that
I can't get mad. I could definitely just walk away. But because you're overstepping the boundary. Like, I wouldn't be mad as if we were in a relationship. Like, I wouldn't say that person cheated on me. Mm-hmm. But I would know where to put that person in my life at that point. Because we set a boundary. We agreed upon it. And you overstepped that boundary.
Okay, if that's something that y'all
But I wouldn't know. Be mad. Like... Any relationship that I've ever had to break up with somebody or that I've been cheated on, like, I literally just feel like that's their loss. Like, it is.
That's what's up.
It's their loss.
That's what you should feel, though.
It's their loss.
You dope as fuck, right?
I am. I'm dope as fuck. I feel like I'm a dope-ass girlfriend. I don't call you. I don't give a fuck where you at. If you say you're going out with your homeboys, be the fuck out with your homeboys. Don't fucking call me, text me, checking in every 5 minutes. That shit's annoying as fuck.
I mean, I care.
I don't need to be up under you. I don't need to be up under you. Like,
that's dope.
You know, I may, and I'm not the easiest person to deal with. Sometimes I don't always like to compromise on stuff, but
I know you for sure ain't compromising.
No, I actually compromise a lot more than I ever have in my life.
That's what's up, because you got a man that makes you want to, right?
Well, because the one time I tried to say some shit to him, he put me in my place real quick. So
that's what's up. Shouts out because, like, you gotta do that shit.
He was like, oof.
Speak down,
I don't remember
huh?
what I said, but he pulled the whole car over and was like, if you think this is how you're gonna talk to me in this relationship, we could go ahead and end it right now.
Yep.
I was like,
and that's what you gotta
do,
because you know y'all be talking out the side of y'all neck sometimes. Like,
I did, but see,
like,
that's because,
y'all be crazy,
but that's because,
man,
I was,
like,
with boys.
I have been with boys. I definitely feel it.
And I have to tell them what to do. You can't tell a man what to do.
There's men that I've talked to like that, but then there's also men that I would never talk to like that. Just
because,
like,
because they
said,
you know what? Some men set a boundary without even actually talking to
you
about it.
Mm-hmm.
From their energy, how they treat you, in the conversation that you have, you will automatically have a boundary set because you know, oh, because of what he's giving me, I know that I can never talk to this person that way.
Yeah.
And a lot of men do that. Yeah, a lot of men can do that.
The old shit that I was doing, it's like certain guys I know that I could probably still do that on, but like there's some that it's like if I ever did that, he'll
be. Yeah, I would say, can we go into depth of the shit?
Like questioning them or just being, or just like catching an attitude. Mm-hmm. There's some men that I know would not tolerate that. Mm-hmm. They'll be like,
because nobody got time for that, especially if it's a fake attitude. Like, come on, let's grow up. Like,
no, for real.
Like, I don't, like, I ain't got time. Like, that energy, I ain't trying to waste my time on that. Like, dead ass. Like,
we almost at the age where babies and marriage is getting here real soon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh, do you guys think that, do people still ask the question? I don't even know.
Ask what question?
Like, okay, we in a relationship now. Like, do you want to be my girlfriend?
No, girl, nobody asks that anymore.
That's crazy.
I think people these days, you kind of, it goes both ways. Because there are sometimes you can just, like, really stumble into a relationship where it's like, oh, we really just been just really hanging tough, where you just stumble. But then there are the moments where you be like, because you really need that full reassurance, like, do you want to or are we? Like, so.
I think social media plays a big part of that nowadays, I think. Because a lot of stuff I
in
remember,
some relationships you don't you won't see my boyfriend on my social media at all.
I mean, I would want to be seen.
Yeah,
that's just me. Maybe because I just look good, so I just be like, hey, check
talk
me
that
out,
talk that talk,
bro.
Like
my business.
Talk that talk.
And it's not about. I mean, I understand that. I like to be a private person too, but
yeah,
it's nothing. It's always good to show your love.
I feel
somebody.
Like the people that are closest to me get to see him, like people who are like, they see, like, you know, whatever I'm posting, like, on certain platforms, then you'll see him, or if you see us out. But I don't post him on my page.
No, I feel that, like I said earlier, case by case basis.
Yeah, we're not even friends on social media.
That's good. I believe in not being friends with whoever you're dating with.
So many things can be.
I feel like
I feel like some things need to be private, and other things like can be so misconstrued.
Yeah, but well, I agree with you.
I'm on social media for funny shit, to be honest with you.
I agree with you there.
So like, if I see something funny, I'm gonna send you it.
It's just
we can laugh and we talk about it.
And that's
send it to him all the time. Menu, copy link, text.
Like, once again, case by case basis. Everybody's like, I don't know. I won't. Okay, let me backtrack on my statement. I don't fully agree with that, but there is moments where you feel like, you know, where, because, like, say, like that whole, like, insecurity, jealous type thing, like people
don't
liking pictures and stuff like that. Whereas if you not following them, then you don't have to worry. You could be in a super solid relationship, but people see people liking stuff and be like, it make me feel some type of way.
That shit is childish to me.
Yeah, that's
no, very childish.
Yeah,
very childish.
If you, like, if okay, they, so but, yeah, then like,
if I see,
so say
if we were friends, right, and it's somebody shaking her ass and he like it, what am I be mad for?
For real.
If I see some ass shaking and I like it, I'm gonna like it too. Yeah. Like,
preach,
it's not
on it.
You get what I'm saying?
It's the comments that's disrespectful. When
if you're commenting something that's inappropriate, then I'll probably have a problem with it. But
look,
I think I told you before, like, I've literally been out with my boyfriend before, and like the next chick that's out with maybe somebody that we're all out with collectively will get upset with me because I'm not mad at him for having a conversation with somebody. But I'm
that's
just
good.
Not that type of person because at the end of the day, we came here together.
Yeah, you know what's up.
And we gonna leave together.
Because you hella secure. But that
usually
only come from insecurities.
And it could be the bitch could look better than me, but she ain't me. And she can't do what the fuck
y'all
do.
Your
period.
Shit.
Yeah.
Like, or shit, y'all might both want
and
her.
And if I don't know about
that too.
But if there and if there is a case where, you know, he decided that he wanted to go fuck around with me or something like that, yo lost, nigga. Like, that's not, like, that.
You gotta move on from it.
And it's just like, and of course it's gonna hurt when you've invested time into somebody and you'll be angry about it, but I'm not gonna lash out and all that other stuff because at the end of the day, I know who I am.
Yeah.
And I know the type of person that, and I feel like that he just made room for the next person that deserves me to have me, period.
See, I love that mindset because I don't understand you women. Not you women, but women that want to, like...
Thank you for correcting yourself, because see,
right.
Champagne
right
here.
I know, because I was looking like, what you mean?
Damn, I missed what you said.
Just in general, like, women that be acting, that be doing crazy shit, like keying cars, breaking, like, that shit.
Bananas.
No.
That to me, I never understood that. I never...
Bananas.
I never
no,
understand that.
No, you got to grow up. That's a childish thing.
Let me
Why are you
going to
damage someone's property? You should just trust the fact that your absence from their life is revenge enough. They not going to have you. That should be revenge. You shouldn't have to
right.
key cars, fuck up shit. I ain't going to... Yeah. I'm not gonna act like I ain't did no destructive shit. Huh? I ain't never keyed nobody car. I don't have the heart to do that because at the end of the day, I still care about them. And who the fuck, like, that's fucked up, you know?
Man, I got my car key before in my ute.
It's okay. It dried. Shit is fucking, it dried. Okay.
Shit is heartbreaking.
But see a car get keyed. I was literally catch engaged. You off guard. I was literally engaged to someone the night that we broke up. The night that we broke up.
You was engaged?
I didn't say, yeah, girl.
Girl.
Sorry. Because I was looking at Moni. I had moved all the way to Chicago and everything. Like, we were living together.
Sheesh. When was this?
It was a whole
2012 to
13. Oh, that's young love right there.
So, look, when we broke up, I said absolutely nothing. It was a Tuesday night. That night, I packed up all my stuff. Wednesday, I shipped it overnight back to California. And Thursday, I flew home. Same week.
Yeah, that's pretty strong, though.
And I didn't say anything.
You didn't, like, cry when you get home? Like, that's a lot of emotion.
It hurt.
She was already... It hurt because it had almost been, like, 5 years. So it hurt. But at the end of the day, I'm never going to keep myself in a situation where I'm unhappy.
Right.
As where it's not going anywhere, and I still have all this life to live.
Yeah,
that's especially that's back not, in 2012, 2013.
How old was you? Like 21?
21, 22.
You wilding. Yeah. You was wilding.
I was living in so Chicago wild? When I turned 22.
Because I'm passionate about that.
I turned 22 when I was still living there.
Yeah.
Damn, girl. You.
So you was just ready to just end all, just everything, like not knowing what else is out there for the world to offer.
It's not at that time, yes, but this is the thing. Me moving out there showed me so much about myself, and then I moved back home, and I spent some time by myself.
Yeah,
like I had to get to know myself. The person that I'm with now, I was not looking for him, and I didn't even want to talk to him. I was actually very rude to him when I first met him. I
believe
what
it.
The fuck are you looking at?
I mean, you very rude in general, but we just
No, but I was really mean to him, and it was just like, why do you want to talk to me? Like, get the fuck, like, that's go.
Probably like, I never understood that question. Why do you want to talk to me? Well, obviously, I'm attracted to you. What do you, right. like, why do you ask that?
But it
she
was just
play.
Like,
that's why.
But it was like so many other people. It was just like, I didn't understand the interest. In, like, I didn't like when people show too much interest in me, it makes me feel uncomfortable.
Why?
Because it's weird. Like, you don't even know me, and you just, like, you're showing too much interest.
It's only weird because you don't have that.
Because, like I said, I'm very nonchalant, like, about stuff. So it was just, like, a lot, like,
You're not reciprocating that same energy. So for you, it was like,
yeah. Like I said, a lot of people didn't even know that we were together when we were together. And to get back to your point, it was just, like, that discussion was never had. So it was never like, oh, so you're my girlfriend now. It was just, like, we went.
So y'all don't have an anniversary?
I don't believe in anniversary unless you're married.
You for sure had like older brothers or like older guy cousins.
Her dad.
You're just different.
That's tight. I mean, I fuck with that.
I just feel like I don't like, she knows I don't like Valentine's Day. It's not my thing.
I don't think nobody
likes Valentine's Day. I feel like that's just stupid. It's stupid.
You don't think nobody likes Valentine's Day?
No, man. I just like, why this one day I have to show you all this love? Like,
if I'm showing you love.
That's why I think it's stupid.
If I'm showing you love throughout the year and we've been down with each other for a minute.
It irritates me.
But if you know
it's
going to make her smile, then just
I get
make
that.
Make me smile every day, nigga.
Yeah. I mean, you definitely team Valentine's Day, I can tell.
Yeah.
I mean, I have no problem doing it. I don't like the whole social.
The pressure.
The hype and the pressure.
I don't like that.
But I feel like women should do stuff for their man, too, though.
Gotta
to
get
make
you
them
one.
Feel special.
Yeah. We hang out on Valentine's Day, but it's not like this whole big thing. Like, we kick it like we do every day.
We play some hoop.
Where we be at?
Right.
At my house. Just happy Valentine's Day.
Well, I'm spending time.
Yeah, but we spend time all the time. So I just don't feel like Valentine's Day that we should spend a whole bunch of money, get me flowers that are going to rot.
Flowers are nice.
I like
flowers, but every time I've got... Actually, he did get flowers delivered to me 1 year for Valentine's Day, and I felt so weird and uncomfortable because I don't do that. I don't do Valentine's Day.
So you're not really like a
soft.
You're like an affectionate person without being affectionate, basically.
I'm very affectionate. Moni will tell you. I'm very affectionate,
no, I know.
But I'm just not.
You're not like a shower.
She of affection. Her love language is like
very freaky.
I love love languages.
Her love language is like I'm gonna. Is acts of service. Yeah.
No, but I feel you on that. You
or
don't
being
need
like,
to be shown love. It's like,
yeah.
I show love through me doing stuff for you, but I don't really necessarily need
it. But I tell people that I love them all the time. Yeah. Like, and I think sometimes it makes people feel uncomfortable because I'll say it before we get off the phone, when you're getting out of my car, when I'm dropping you off, mm-hmm. like whatever. Like that's just how I am.
I'm not good at that. I'm not good at saying I love you.
You know what? It changed for me as I got older because it was so many of my friends like passing away and like getting killed that, and I wasn't used to that growing up. But like since maybe like 2016 or so, I felt like it was so important to always tell people that you love them. And I've been doing it ever since then. Moni will tell you that. Like I tell her I love her all the time.
That's a good perspective to think of it.
Oh, if I don't text them when I make it home, they be ready to fight.
Like, bitch.
I understand.
I said, text me when you make it home.
I remember I seen on Twitter when a girl said, I text you when I get home. And a dude put, nigga, I don't give a damn if you get home or not. That's just all I think of.
That's
like that.
Fucked up.
Yeah,
it's not. It's really funny. I understand why, because basically he didn't hit. That's why it's funny to me.
Oh my gosh. Oh wow. But no. But to answer your question, Moni, I don't know if like adults really have that conversation anymore. Like for me, it just kind of came up. It was like we were somewhere, and it was like, oh yeah, my girl. I was like, oh.
I've only had like one adult relationship, and it was just like it was with the same guy that told me that I wasn't his girl.
So you bullied him.
No, nigga, I'm your girl. No, nigga. It was later, and we was having a conversation about something, probably me walling on something like he was at work.
I gotta just do it.
He was at work, and I'm like, oh, I said something. He was like, yeah, everybody in there know I got a girl, and I was like, oh you got a girl.
I probably told you. Smiling hardest.
Oh my god, right.
Just cheesing.
I was like,
That's funny.
But yeah,
I don't think that that's a question anymore.
That's crazy.
That's what's up, man.
Well, shit.
How long y'all been together?
4 years now, a little over 4 years.
Oh shit. So okay, so I got a question. Mm-hmm. So, like, I know how you were saying like y'all vibe is like you wouldn't really know y'all together. Mm-hmm. So that don't mean y'all not like awkward when y'all out, right?
No. Are we awkward when we're out?
Nah, they just act cool.
Exactly. Like y'all just basically chill. Like,
so
y'all seen this shit before.
Me, Moni, and Meese, we all went out to the parlor.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to the parlor.
Before we even got in line, Moni was like, guess who here? And I'm like, oh, shit, it's some group niggas here that they know or whatever. And then I heard her say my boyfriend's name. And I'm sitting, see this nigga standing in line. I'm like, what the fuck you
that's
doing
tight.
Here?
Yeah.
Because he's not a go out person. Like, that's not his thing. But I always ask him, like, oh, like, you know. Yeah.
Probably want to catch a game.
So he, like, surprised us or whatever. And he came out. And then, like, and there was some people, too. I had a few people ask me, like, oh, my God, like, you dancing with these dudes and your boyfriend? I was like, the fuck, why I can't dance with somebody?
Okay, now that's, to me, that's a little awkward.
It's crazy.
You got to be real secure.
Very
like,
secure.
Like, real secure.
If you, okay, it's a way to dance with people, like, ain't nobody about to be picking me up, like, gyrating me stuff.
No,
like, not none of that. But it's like, if you just, like, a guy was, like, holding my hand. We, like, two-stepping whatever. I'm, like, dancing, like, in front of somebody. Like, it's not like a...
Now, you grinding on him?
Yeah, like, I'm not finna grind on nobody. Okay. I'm not even, like, I'm not finna grind on nobody. But at the end of the day, like, he not tripping. I don't care. He could go dance with somebody and do all the other stuff. Like, we weren't all up under each other. I was literally with my friends and with him. Like, I went back and forth, but it wasn't awkward.
I was very surprised that y'all separated. Because I was like, oh, shit, y'all not finna be booed up, but...
No, I'm not. I don't know.
Everybody different.
Yeah.
They different.
Ain't no way a dude about to go dance on other girls if his girl is there. Ain't no way.
Nah.
It's no way. I would never.
I just... Cause
I'd be like, okay.
Because I just feel like that...
I don't know.
But
you're right. It's a security thing.
Security?
He doesn't give me any reason to feel insecure about anything.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
The
like,
communication that we have, like, is just like that. If he didn't want to be with me anymore, he would just tell me that.
No, yeah.
And it'll
like,
be,
I don't even know... I don't know you well enough. And I don't even know your boyfriend at all. I don't know your relationship. But just how you've been talking, I can tell, like, y'all had some time together, and it's like, I ain't, like, you're not worried about shit.
Yeah, no. Because
you, like, oh, you're like, I mean, it's like,
they 3 years or more, it's just, we
at
together.
At that point, it's like, you ain't got, once you really get past that 3-year mark, it's like, all right, we solid. Although there's been breakups with people in 4 or 5 plus years, that shit happens too, but...
I think a big part of that, too, is that sometimes people force themselves to still be in the relationship because of how much time they invested.
Yeah.
And I don't think that anyone should ever do that. I feel like you need to build a foundation first. And I only feel like the only reason this relationship that I'm in now, I feel like the only reason it's successful is because of communication. There's never been a time. There's never been a time where we had an argument where we were yelling and cursing at each other out. There's never been disrespect. If there's a problem, you communicate it, and then when there's a next argument, you don't bring up old shit. Is we in this situation now? Yeah. This is what we're discussing, and we're either gonna agree, disagree, agree to disagree, and move forward, and then that's it.
I feel that.
So
but,
we just go dead all the old shit.
But I don't ever. I don't. You will never catch me. I never bring up anything that we've discussed.
It's hard to get the old shit.
If, if there was an issue, if there was an issue, if we discussed it and resolved it and moved on from it, I do not bring it up again.
Like, nah, but
and I don't. I don't expect him to bring it up because at the end of the day, that means you didn't really forgive whatever the situation or it wasn't really resolved, which means you're a liar. And you just try
I love the way women say the word liar. Like, it just come off y'all tongue a different way. Like, it pops off y'all tongue. It's
lying ass nigga.
You go talk a little kid voice.
Yeah, like the way women say liar, I love it. It's hilarious to me.
Oh Lord. So every episode we're ending with a quote. So the quote
get
today
deep on this
is something that y'all probably it's very simple, something that y'all probably heard before from y'all older relatives. Why buy the cow when you can get the milk for free?
Definitely heard this.
And Keyshawn touched on this earlier when he was saying, like, why give me the title if we
if
already
I'm already
shit?
Doing everything carefree with no title. Exactly.
Yeah.
That's true.
So for women and men, if you feel like you're going to be caught up of, like, them not giving you a title, then you can't be acting like y'all in a relationship either.
It happens. It does happen to guys, too, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. Where it's like.
I kind of have a question. Why do some guys feel like, so they'll tell a girl like, oh, we're not together, this, that, and the third. But why is it a true double standard for you not wanting the girl to do things, but you feel like it's okay for you to do?
That sucks.
Do things as far as what? Like,
she's basically like just the male double standard, right?
Yeah, because it is a true double standard. It's just like, if a girl is out here doing this, and that, she's looked at a certain way, but guys doing it is just them being a guy.
That's just society norms. Like, it sucks.
And I've seen guys tell a girl, like, oh, no, you can't do that. Like,
oh,
that
no,
shit,
yeah,
not cool,
we all
blah,
know.
Blah, but he doing his shit, and I'm
I think
that's just how the world made it.
Yeah.
It's something like, before we even knew about it, that's like, how the world made it. So, and then once we learn from it, and then we just all stuck with it.
And it's just society norms. Yeah. Like, as a guy, I can really say double standards suck. Like, it does. Because, like, you feel me? I have women in my family. Like, you feel me? So, I usually see arguments from both sides when it comes to battle of the sexes. But it's just like, that's just a society norm. It's just the whole male double standard. It sucks because, and like he said, like, that came around before us. Like, the stuff that goes on now in dating and shit, this is nothing new.
Going on before.
Shit's been going on since the beginning of dating and shit. So, it's just the times change because we got a whole social media and all that stuff. So, it just changes everything. So,
I think
but none of this shit is new.
People who's mature enough and understand the stuff, like, if a girl's out here messing with niggas, I couldn't be mad at her. Because if he out here messing with hoes, I mean, my bad, I can't say girls are hoes. If girls are messing with niggas and niggas are messing with other girls.
That's the one of them generalizations.
You know what I'm saying? It's nothing.
You don't mean hoes in a bad way when you say it like that.
Niggas is hoes too. Niggas is hoes too.
Niggas is hoes.
Yep.
Niggas is the biggest hoes.
See, look, there it is. You didn't have
that's the battle of the sex. She had to throw that jab in there.
You have to put 1A, 1B.
But once again, if you say niggas are the biggest hoes, that goes back to what you said earlier. There's just more women out here. So,
yeah. I mean, it must be rough for y'all. Like, I can admit that. It must be rough for y'all not to cheat because...
I'm single, by the way. Anybody is watching, all ladies.
It's harder...
I was just about to say, plug your shit.
It's harder for us to cheat because it's like... bum niggas, like, you know?
Oh, my God.
But
y'all didn't see her face when she said...
Any nigga who did Simone wrong... Y'all gotta use a bum one, and y'all might have to run a fade.
Use a bum nigga.
Because that was some deep feeling that just came out.
No, like, but I mean, like, it's like beautiful women that are, like, out of y'all league that will, like...
Nobody's out of my league, sweetie.
It's crazy, because it be some chicks that you be thinking like really out of your league, and you be like, damn, I could really get her. Well, she really feel me.
Because that's how it
shouts
is
shout out to
in
the
LA.
Young me who didn't realize that back
I really
in the
don't
day.
Feel like anybody's out, lost out on is some out teams. Of anyone's league. Did you but see my caption today on Instagram? What you put? It said... It's not that I'm better than you. I'm just better than that.
Ooh. Mm. Okay.
All right, talk that talk then, girl. Talk that talk.
Wait, say that again, my bad.
It's not that I'm better than you. I'm just better than that.
Yeah, and that's just what it is.
See, and people think that, like, people are quick to say, oh, you think you better than me. No, bitch. I'm just better than all this shit you doing.
Yeah, I'm not stupid. I'm better
than
that.
And it's the same. Right. It's the same to niggas. I don't think I'm better than you. Niggas be quick to be like, oh, you think you better. Like, no, I don't think I'm better than you. I'm just better than what I know that you can give me.
I just ain't got the time and energy to be dealing with that shit.
Exactly. I believe in myself a lot. That's all it is.
Yep.
I believe in me.
Yep. Yeah. So.
That's good.
Now plug time. You guys time. Plug time. Plug whatever.
Man, I ain't even supposed to be here right now.
Plug.
I knew he was gonna talk. I knew he was gonna talk.
You know, I can't help but not talk. Y'all know I like to talk.
So we
especially
say like,
on stuff like this.
Social media and all that type of stuff. What is my social media thing?
I don't know social media.
Right.
They're all different names though.
They are different.
How many you got? Stalker?
I got one.
You got stalker Instagrams? Everything.
Nah. I do photography too.
Oh, okay.
Oh, is that you, Living Life Photos?
Yeah, that's me.
I got Life Photos. She just said that.
Plug
Living
that too.
Life Photos. Living Life Photos. You need some photo shoots, some photos, anything, hit your boy. Or you can find me at stayhumble_key 811, sweetie. You know what I'm saying? For the ladies out there, I am single. Oh, y'all can't even see me, huh? Can they see me?
Yeah, they put you on the social. On IG.
Yeah, I'm single, ladies. So I can
go ahead once again, me. It's your boy, Mark. I'm not even supposed to be here right now.
So, why are you going to say that?
Because I just need people to know, but I enjoy myself. Yeah, unlike him, I live a life that's not confusing. So I just got one name, @MHDeuce, for everything. My shit is boring, so you don't even want to follow me. I just plugged it because...
I didn't find you.
How you not find me?
You don't know how to spell Deuce.
You probably don't. It's D-E-U-C-E.
Speaking of that, I gave him that nickname, by the way, people. Just throwing that out there.
Only reason why it's a nickname is because I'm a junior, and my social is like Mark Henderson II. But it's dope. I thank you for giving me that because it's hard. I ran with it. I used to be Marky Mark, and I glowed up.
Friends forever.
Do people still use Snapchat? I don't feel like people be snapping no more.
Did you still not find it?
Anybody can have. I'm going to watch that when I get home.
I use Snapchat.
Snapchat is dead, low-key.
I use Snapchat to record the video.
And put it on Insta story.
Yes, yeah. It's because I like how the Snapchat videos still do its thing.
I've been having some fire selfies, though.
Yeah.
Fire selfies. Exactly.
They just better.
Fire selfies, fire video. Like, Snap, I use it and then go to IG.
Y'all wildin'.
But I use both. Shout out to the IG story. I was hating on it in the first, but not
mine.
Me too.
Now I fuck with it.
I fuck with
it. All the posts and stuff.
Well, thank all of you guys for listening. Be sure to follow us on Instagram @NeverNotExtra and our personal pages @higher.levels.only and Moni Meets World.
Moni Meets
on
World.
Instagram.
I'm going to change it soon. Change it back to the OG name.
What was your OG name?
Middle Like Moni.
Middle Like Moni.
Real Freaky Moni.
Yeah, man. Thanks for having me, you know?
Yeah, thank
Even
you.
Though I wasn't
thank you guys
supposed
for
to be
coming.
Here, you know?
We appreciate y'all. Coming. Great combo.
Man, this was fun.
This was fun. I'm kind of mad y'all didn't hit me up about the Never Not Insecure. Because I was really about that.
Why didn't you say so?
I don't know.
Oh,
I don't
my
know.
God. This...
But I definitely... Shout out to Lawrence Hyde. We still here. Always and forever. But I see... But once again, I see from both sides. You know, you got to see both sides.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
But it's Never Not Insecure. I see y'all season, 4 next year?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, talk to me.
Whenever
4.
That come out.
Whenever y'all want to invite me, let me know.
Be sure to tune in. Be sure to tune in every Tuesday at 8:30 p.m.
Y'all got no weekend shows y'all do?
No, nigga.
Y'all only nighttime and niggas got work in the morning.
You don't have to listen live.
Yeah, it's always recorded.
No, I know that.
Oh, you mean to like be a guest star?
Yes,
oh,
to be a guest star.
We'd be tired too.
I'm tired. Download the Good News Radio app.
Yes,
and to listen to all of our fellow mates.
Mm-hmm.
On, we got Willis in the house. Chill Will. His show is
Shout
on
Chill Will.
Monday.
In the building.
Sunday evening at 5.
What's your show called, dog?
Chill Will.
Chill Will? That's it? What'd you be talking about, Chill Will?
Mental health, and he's qualified to talk about it because he went
up.
To school for it.
That shit is important.
Yeah, that's
especially
a big,
in the black community.
I'm glad my
Shout
mental
out.
Health is together because
to
I've
Will.
Definitely had moments where it wasn't, but I got that thing in order.
That's what's up. I'm looking for a therapist now. This is like a side conversation.
College had me
stressed. I'm trying to find a black woman therapist.
Well, let's do our outro. What's the outro song you requested?
Oh, yeah. What did you say? I meant to pull that up.
We talking to you, Mark.
Yeah, this nigga.
What? What did you say?
What's the outro
some song that
you
said?
You requested.
Oh, Trey Song, Shame My Girl.
either Trey Song or Sammy, one of the two.
I mean, let me see what other.
Oh my god, I love Sammy.
I'm trying to think. What Nah, we need a better song for we talking about somebody ain't my girl. Come on, Key. We need some.
She Ain't My Girl is really a good song. Yeah, you listen to it, though.
There we go, right there talking about the Sammy.
It is.
I like bro, it's a full girl. Trey song. It's on Anticipation.
You know, like yeah, he it. Got it from Sammy.
I didn't know that.
Oh, it was a remake?
Well, Anticipation was a mixtape. So.
Oh, all right. Good night, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
She ain't my